I discovered I like pistachios. I didn't know this about myself. I learned this when I helped this van who got stuck in the sand the other day. Pulled them out. They tried to give me money. I was like, no, no, no. It took like 2 seconds. I don't need money for that. Plus, it was just something fun to do. So on the way out, they stopped, came up, gave me this little like grocery bag of goodies.
Well, that was sweet. She brought a little goodie bag.
Are you proud of yourself for scaring off the threat? I know, she was dangerous.
She brought a goodie bag full of snacks.
So I was just like, okay, fine. So I took it. There's pistachios in there. I've never really eaten pistachios that I'm aware of. And they're from Trader Joe's. I'm afraid I can't afford them. But now I like them, which is an issue. I should have just taken the money. It would have been cheaper for them, or for me. All right, let's start the video.
Social media, where I can share every aspect of my life with you. A heavily edited, filtered, sometimes even scripted life.
When you make videos sharing your life, it can be kind of hard to know where that line is. If something good happens and you share it, are you just bragging? If there's something bad or sad happening and you share it, you become vulnerable or sometimes even lose subscribers. There's no manual for this sort of stuff. There's no guidebook. There's no instructions. In fact, the videos that have been the most real have the highest subscriber loss counts.
Sometimes I struggle to balance what I share.
Perception can be very misleading. For example, we could be miles, hundreds of miles from civilization out in some mountain canyon. Or we could be 500 yards from a major interstate. Middle of nowhere mountain canyon? Interstate. Perception. You see us out here on this grand adventure? Me not working? I must be rich. You see me smiling? Having a good time? I must be happy.
Every video uploaded sees subscribers come and go. I've been doing this long enough, I kind of know what to expect. And when it gets too real, people bail. Now, to be fair, I don't let this deter me because, as they say, if you can't handle me at my worst, I won't lie. Sometimes I pretend to be happy. Honestly, I do this more for myself than for your benefit. I know the subscribers lost are not the subscribers I want to have anyway, but negativity breeds more negativity. So I'd rather try my best to focus on the good and the positive, making videos that are happy. I've uploaded well over 100 videos to YouTube, probably more like 200 to 300. I forget not everyone sees every video, so it's understandable if you get confused. Let me clarify some details.
Now let's take a look at some of these details. Truck, bought used. Airstream, also bought used. Airstream down payment. Remember me selling my Evo? All the items that I bought for the Airstream, for the truck, for this adventure. Do you remember me selling a house and most of my possessions? My total each month for the truck and the Airstream, $1,100 a month, give or take a few. That's less than what my mortgage was. Not to mention that the upkeep expense of the truck and the Airstream, much less than a house. You see the new truck. The dusty, very filthy new truck. You see the new Airstream. You see us driving thousands of miles from home. You know the gas prices are record highs. In fact, right now here in California, over $6 a gallon. And then there's what you don't see. You don't see me going to work. You don't see me going to get a job. So it's very obvious that I must be rich. I must be. We must be. We must. We're rich. Did you know this? I didn't know this.
Post-launch mid-afternoon walk. Think was a success. Come on. Go on.
Homemade french fries. Oh, french fries now. Just like magic.
There's no way around it. Gas prices suck right now, but they suck everywhere. We left Cincinnati on March 6th. We arrived in California on April 19th. That's 44 days. I won't bore you with the math. I'm currently averaging just over 1,500 miles per month. I bet many of you drive that in a month. And my average continues to drop. I estimate by the end of the year, I'll be driving an average of, wait for it, 830 miles per month.
Well, let's go back out.
Welcome to the Alabama Hills. We're still in California, but you'll notice it's a little bit different. We started this video in Joshua Tree. We are now many, many miles away. And that's why I want to use this to explain why I don't just go home and get a job, as some people say. I love Ohio, but let's be real. Rent an apartment in Ohio, get a job working 40 hours a week plus commute time, or do this. Welcome to Oklahoma City. Welcome to New Mexico on Arizona Views. Welcome to California. I think I'll choose this. To all the people who leave those comments, you just might as well change your username to hater. Not to mention, even if you think this isn't a good life for pups and Rally, them being alone all day every day would be worse. Right? Yeah. Plus, I do have a job. You see it in every video that I post. YouTube is my job. The majority of my income comes from YouTube, whether it's the ads that play in the video, merch, affiliates, or my favorite people in the whole world, Patreon. And as I said, as beautiful as Ohio can be, let's face it, traveling around the country, chasing views, way more entertaining from a video perspective than just going to the same parks over and over again. Now, are we rich? Hardly. Actually, no, not even a little bit. But I minimized as many expenses as I could, and we get by. Do I have money to splurge on fancy dinners and cars and clothes or whatever? No. So yes, I did a GoFundMe for the pups so that they could get an AC unit. This may seem like a frivolous thing to you, but to the people that just say, well, you should just completely abandon this life you've created and go rent an apartment, I don't know where you're gonna find an apartment that's cheaper than what I'm paying, and then I would have to get a job to afford it. If I need to eat ramen noodles every day, I'll do that. I don't care. But when it comes to the pups, I'll do whatever it takes for them, including asking for help. Now, to be clear, I know most of you wish nothing but the best for us. And I am eternally grateful for that. As I said, I know not everybody watches every video, and perceptions can be intentional or unintentional. If I have to, every video I make, explain that, hey, I do YouTube for a living, hey, I'm able to afford this because of this, if I have to do a basic Q&A every single video, never get anything else done. Every video would just be that. And then Lotus chasing shadows, right? So please, don't take this video as a rant or me complaining or anything like that. It's really just me trying to clear the air and hopefully provide some perception.
Can we go have dinner? Hi, Rally.
As I mentioned, this video is not meant to be a rant. It's not meant to address the criticism even per se. It's more just to clarify. I know lots of you watch every video and none of this is new to you, but I also understand that not everybody can watch every video, so hopefully this will be a video that I can reference for those who are new or just need to get caught up. Keep in mind, no matter what happens, no matter if the videos are happy or sad, I'm just grateful to be able to do this and to be able to share it. And to each one of you who like and subscribe and share our videos And especially the Patreons. You're the world to me, and I love you all. Good night. Air.